That's super interesting and a very good explanation. If you look at the scale of your company, what's the easiest way to explain the scale of your company and also how big the ships are? I read somewhere, I don't know if it's correct, but it said that one of your biggest ship can hold the energy, the oil consumption of Britain and France in one day. So if that's correct or nearly correct, it says something about the enormous scale of both the ships and your company.
No, absolutely. So if we start with the fun element, which are the ships that we operate. So we operate three types of ships, the Suezmax, and they're called Suezmax because the biggest ship that can go through the Suez Canal on a fully laden, i.e. with a full cargo, and they can carry 1 million barrel of oil. The other size that we have, we have many more of those, is are the VLCCs, the very large crude carrier, and they were invented really at a time when the Middle East became a very important hub for exporting of oil, and vast majority at that time of the vessels were going to the US, and so people were looking for economies of scale. So they said, we're going to double the size of a Suezmax. And it makes sense because the journey is very long, so you consume more, less, etc., etc. And they can carry 2 million barrels at a time. And then there are very few, but we own all of them. Very few ships that can carry 3 million barrels. They are obviously even bigger than a VLCC. They are mostly used for storage, in fact, not so much for transportation. And initially, we thought that the fleet was going to grow and that it would become the standard, but it didn't, because the market structure was not set to carry or to trade 3 million barrels at the time, and 2 million barrels is already a lot. And you need to think about the customer who is asking you to do that. 2 million barrels in today's world is $160 million worth of cargo. 160 million. Back in 2014, it was more than 200 million, because the oil prices were more than $100 a barrel. So you can see that the amount of money that you need to be a trader in those markets, and therefore to need the services of a shipping company, is quite big. So when you look at the size, well, in length, a Suezmax will be 220 meters. A VLCC will be 280 meters, and then a ULCC, an ultra large crude carrier, will be probably 330 meters. So 330 meters for the golfers, that's longer, or it's the size of a par five. So it tells you a lot. And if you put it vertically, it's just smaller than the Eiffel Tower in Paris. So it's absolutely gigantic. Now, in terms of height, when you take the ship on the dry and put it next to you, it's 60 meter high. Now, 60 meter high is the equivalent of 22 floor building, 22 floor building. So it's absolutely gigantic. So it's very impressive to realize that human beings are capable of building those gigantic tools, and those things are moving around the world in the ocean. They are made of steel. They are very, very heavy, and fortunately they float, thanks to physical laws, of course. Every time I visit the ship, and every time I go to the shipyards who is finishing the building of a ship, and you know, we have big ceremonies to name the ship, so there's a lot of tradition in the industry. You know, I've been in this industry 17 years, and every single time I'm like, oh my God, this is for real. This is gonna move, carry oil in a very safe way, but this is gonna float. This is gonna be there for 20 years or more. So I'm as an engineer, obviously, I completely admire these mammoths. And the last element that people need to understand is it's not because it's made of steel that it doesn't move. So there is quite, when you put that ship on the water, you can't see it, but obviously if you look at the simulator, you will understand that because the water is exercising different kind of pressure on the hull, then it's the entire ship which is bending in many different ways, but obviously within a what we call a life fatigue, which means that they will be very solid for 20 years, but it's also the reason why after 20 years we need to retire them, because the steel has been fatigued enough, and we don't want to take any risk that it breaks.